गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लास्ट वीडियो में हम डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज रिप्रोडक्शन एंड ऑल्सो आई डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ द डीएनए कॉपीइंग ड्यूरिंग रिप्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस एस्पेशली इन एसेक्सुअल मोड ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन एंड ऑल्सो हाउ डिस्कस अबाउट द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ द वेरिएशन हाउ इट इज हेल्पफुल इन ऑर्गेनिज्म टू सर्वाइव अंडर अनफेवरेबल कंडीशन दैट इज व्हाट यू हैव डिस्कस्ड. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन. So what are the different types of reproduction followed by different organism to continue their generations? So that is we are going to discuss now. So types of reproduction. So the organism according to their organization of organ system, different organism follows different mode of reproduction. Like the reproduction can be two types: asexual mode of reproduction and sexual mode of reproduction. So these are the two types of reproduction that is performed by different types of organisms according to their organization of organ systems. Now we are going to discuss about in detail what is asexual mode of reproduction and how it is occurring and what are the features of asexual mode of reproduction and also what are the advantages and disadvantages which are chances to be occurred by means of asexual mode of reproduction, and same process we can discuss in sexual mode of reproduction also. Now let me discuss in detail about the asexual mode of reproduction. So what is asexual mode of reproduction? So asexual means without involvement of the two parents or without involvement of the gametes. Means in this process of asexual mode of reproduction, single organism is able to produce their young ones without fusion of the gamete, and that's why it is called as asexual mode of reproduction. So what is asexual mode of reproduction? Means single organism produce their young ones. Single organism produce their young ones. And another important event which is not occurring in this process of reproduction is there is no production of gametes. So if there is no production of gametes, means no fusion of the gametes and no fertilization, no zygote formation takes place. That's what. So during the process of asexual mode of reproduction, single organism able to produce their young ones, and what is another important is here, no fusion of the gametes. So without fusion of gametes. So without fusion of gametes. So that's what it is called as asexual mode of reproduction. So this mode of reproduction is occurring in unicellular organisms like bacteria and protozoans. And also it occurs in case of plants like algae, fungi and some other bryophytes. So these are the examples for plants, and also occurs in multicellular animals, in case of animals also like sponges, and also occurs in hydra. So these are the some of the examples of organisms that allows to perform the mode of asexual reproduction. So according to the level of organization, according to their condition, these organisms are following this method of reproduction. So what are the examples of asexual mode of reproduction is unicellular organism like bacteria and protozoans. In case of plants, you can take algae, fungi and bryophytes, and also we can take in case of animals like sponges and hydras. So these are the some of the examples of the organism that generally used to follow asexual mode of reproduction. Now let me discuss some important features of asexual mode of reproduction. So what is asexual reproduction means? Single organism produce their young ones without fusion of gametes. That is asexual mode of reproduction. And what are the examples? Like unicellular organism, bacteria, protozoans. In case of plants, you can take algae, fungi and bryophytes. And in case of animals, you can take sponges and hydra. So these are the some of the examples of the asexual reproducing organisms. Now let me discuss the features. What are the important features which is takes place in case of asexual reproduction? So features. So features of asexual mode of reproduction. So here only one organism is essential in this process. So only one organism. Only one organism is needed to produce their young ones. If only one organism is involved during this process, so what is happening here? There is no requirement of male and female both. Only one is required. And if there is no requirement of male and female different organism, there is no production of gametes. Gametes are not produced. Gametes is nothing but male and female cells. So that is called sex cells, which are produced in different organisms. Male animals produce male gametes, female organisms produce female gametes. But in case of in asexual reproduction, there is no involvement of the two different organisms. Hence, there is no production of gametes. If there is no gametes are produced, there is no fusion of the gametes. So no fusion of gametes. If there is no fusion of gametes, there is no fertilization to be occurred. So no fertilization is occurring. No fertilization is occurring. If there is no fertilization is occurring, there is no formation of zygote. Zygotes are not formed. That is what? Zygotes or zygote is not formed. If there is no formation of zygote, what is happening here means? So in generally, if fertilization is occurring, so what is fertilization? Fusion of male and female gametes to produce a single diploid cell is called as a zygote. So this zygote is which is very very essential for the exchange of genetic material which is formed during replication, as what we have discussed. So double stranded DNA which is formed from the gametes. So here during the fertilization process, two different DNAs from the parent, and that is from male and female, both the DNAs are joined together, that is fused together, and the genetic material is going to be exchanging here. That is going to be occur during fertilization and formation of zygote. So here there is no fertilization, there is no formation of zygote, means there is no exchanging of genetic material. So how the parent characteristics are existed in this organism, that characteristics are as easily carried forward to the new formed organisms. That is, the newly formed organisms are young ones are genetically non-identical. Non-identical means what? Which is both are similar. Parent genetic material as well as newly formed young ones genetic material. Both the genetic material is non-identical. So non-identical genetic material is found in case of offsprings that are formed during asexual mode of reproduction. That's what the genetically non-identical offsprings which are formed by the process of this method, that organisms are also called as clones. So clones is nothing but as it is like copy paste. What is that? The DNA structure is present in the parent, that is as easily carry forward to the new offsprings without any changing, without any alteration in structure of the DNA molecule. That's what in offsprings they are genetically non-identical to the parents. That's what they are also called as clones. These are also called as clones. So what is next we are to discuss is genetically non-identical. So non-identical means which is as easily DNA getting from parent. So genetic material is in both cases it is similar. That's what it is called as genetically non-identical. And genetically non-identical offsprings which are formed by means of asexual mode of reproduction, that organisms are also called as clones. What they are called? Clones. So what is clone means? So genetically non-identical offsprings are young ones formed by the process of asexual reproduction. That's what. So without any change in structure of the DNA, new organisms are formed. This is we can called as genetically non-identical offsprings. So hence that formed new organisms called as clones. That is, we can create as easily what we use. For example, if you cut and plant one rose, red color rose, so the new developing plant is also able to produce red color roses only. That is, parent is red in color and the daughter, that is new plant, also in red color. That is what the gene which is essential for the formation of red color is also found in new plant. That's what they are genetically non-identical offsprings or new organisms or young ones which are formed by the process of asexual reproduction. This is what we have to remember, some of the important characteristic features of the asexual reproduction. So what are the important features is, so here only one organism is needed. There is no production of gametes. If there is no gametes are produced, no fusion of gametes, no fertilization occurs, and there is no zygote form. If there is no zygote formation takes place, there is no exchange of genetic material, and hence the newly formed offsprings, they carries the genetic material as easily from the parent. Hence they are called as genetically non-identical. And these genetically non-identical offsprings which are formed, they are called as clones. And if there is no exchanging of genetic material in case of offsprings, there is no new variation, new characteristics. So that newly formed organism may chances to survive or may chances to the death. Why? Because if a parent is having a severe disease, so that as easily carry forward to the newly formed offspring. So that's what genetically non-identical organisms may have. The what are the characteristic features of the DNA is coding, that is carry forwarding, and maybe it is showing effective or non-effectively for them to survive. And this is multiple rapidly, that is the development of the organism by this method takes place very rapidly, very fastly. Why? Because the cell division takes place by means of a process called as mitosis division. So under mitosis process of cell division, what is happening here? The cell division is occurring very rapidly. That is, one cell is divided into two, two cells are again four, four again eight, 8, 16, 16 to 13. That is what the multiplication of new cells is occurring rapidly and helps in development of organisms very rapid. That's what. So in case of these, the mitotic division is going to be occur. Mitotic division is occurring that allows in rapid growth. That is rapid multiplication. This is what we can see in case of asexual mode of reproduction. Now, let me discuss about types of asexual reproduction. What are the different types of asexual reproduction that is performed by different organisms? That we have to discuss. I hope understand. Now, we will discuss about types of asexual mode of reproduction. So, the organisms, according to their organ level of organization, they follows different methods of reproduction. So, as we know that under asexual mode of reproduction types, so the organisms, they follows fission, that is one method, fragmentation, that is one, spore formation, regeneration, budding. This is what. And in case of plants, you can take vegetative propagation, and also we can see that tissue culture. These are the various methods. Here there is not any two organisms to involve in production of new offsprings. So only one parent is itself able to produce new offsprings. So, according to their organization of organ system, they used to follow various method of reproduction like fission, fragmentation, spore formation, regeneration, budding, vegetative propagation, and tissue culture. So, again, vegetative propagation, various methods are followed by the different plants according to their body parts, and tissue culture, it is one of the artificial development of the desired characteristics which is carried out in laboratory artificial conditions. These are the various methods of asexual mode of reproduction. So what is fission? What is fragmentation? What about spore formation? All the things we will discuss in later class.